What's up guys, welcome to today's video. It's a nice, cool, relaxing day out. I apologize, I did take the last 2 days off. One of the days was Pat's birthday and then I did a little BMX riding, just kind of hanging out with the guys. And then the other day I went Christmas shopping, got gifts for everybody all taken care of. And then today's kind of like the last day of just resetting everything before the holidays. So kind of going over the shop, going over a couple of the builds. Alberto's finishing up the clutch on the Evo. How'd it go, Alberto?
Pretty good.
Yeah, and just so you guys know, ow, I just hit my head on the lift post. I did listen to you guys. I got Alberto a set of AirPods, so you can stop asking. Everyone was concerned that your headbuds were gonna get caught in the engine.
They did.
Oh yeah?
All the time, still get tangled and stuff.
Yeah, remember that time when they got caught around the crank pulley when I was revving the car and then they ripped out of your ears violently?
Oh my god, I know. That was the scariest moment ever.
That didn't happen. That drive shaft's pretty sweet, right? One of the things I want to do while the Evo is down, just quickly replace the axle boot. So I put a fresh one on here. The other one had a teeny weeny hole in it and it was flinging stuff everywhere. So that's done. Now Jamie's going to help me get the tune on this thing super finalized today. So I'm going to do another quick boost leak test just to make sure this thing's all set before I go and try to tune a car with boost leaks. Found two cracks already, or two leaks I should say, look. Yep. Line is super pressure regular. That'll affect it. My intercooler also has like a little hairline crack, so I'm going to try to JB weld that up at least. We do it all the time on our cars at Evisu, so it's the best thing I can do right about now. It's weird, I don't even think it's rainy season, but the rain's been starting to ruin all my plans like over and over again. So I wanted to go tune the Skyline tonight or test drive the Evo with a new clutch, which is done now, but it's raining out and I don't feel like, you know, I mean, I guess I could test the clutch in the rain, but it's not important. I'll probably get back to it tomorrow. Pretty cool seeing how many cars we can stack up in the shop. Going away for some of the holiday stuff, so I was just kind of get everything in here. So anyway, I'm kind of at a loss for content at the shop. So I think I'm gonna do is go home. I also have all this nice trim for my other GZX that maybe I'll put in, try to get that interior looking a little bit better. Morning guys, it is the day after Christmas, starting off the day ripping over the Chaser to the shop. I think I mentioned to you guys before, though, switching out some of the trim. So I started getting some of the Cool Tour V trim in. Still a little mix-matched in here with all the different color interiors, but I'm slowly trying to piece this thing together and make it look nice. So gonna go to the shop and tinker with some stuff today. Okay, bye. Cup holders in this thing, not satisfactory. Having to do the balancing act while driving stick, and it's very difficult. Children better feel special that I got him a coffee. Unlike me, but I do want to break in the clutch on the Evo, especially if I'm going to be doing any sort of launches with it. I want to make sure that I break it in properly. So right now I just warm this thing up. I'm going to do a quick oil change on it and a couple other little maintenance things before I take it back out. I do change my oil much more frequently than most people do. A lot of it's because I do run E90 and that tends to affect the oil more. I also tend to drive my cars very hard and track days and stuff. So especially with a built engine, it's a good idea to change your oil a little bit more frequently than, you know, your average person that does it every thousands of miles. Another issue I've been dealing with in the back of the head, there's this little fitting and it's all deteriorated. There's like a rubber grommet and it just doesn't last. I tried to RTV it, so we're gonna replace it with something better. Ugh, look at that. All shot. So I just got the newer style Evo setup from MA Performance. This is like, it's like a check valve built into this thing, so there's no need for rubber grommet, and then this will just press right into the valve cover. Eventually I've got to run that line to the catch cam, but for now it looks so much better than that setup that was in there before with the rubber grommet falling apart. There shouldn't be leaking oil up here anymore. So hopefully between that and fixing all the axle stuff down below, we don't have any more leaks anymore. But I'm excited to go try the new LSD and the new clutch. Kind of annoying on days like this where I'm just kind of doing tedious stuff because I spent probably half the day just sorting through a bunch of weird wiring issues that this car was having. When I switched the trim, some wires got pulled out because the way the gauges were wired before was kind of sketchy. So I ended up redoing all that. I had to redo the cigarette lighter wiring. Probably should have filmed it. I've read mixed things about breaking in the LSDs in the front of stuff like Evos and all-wheel drive cars. The general consensus is to do figure eights for a while to kind of help break it in, so the plates don't make a bunch of clunking and wear in a weird way. But some LSDs also say that you don't need to do it. So I'm gonna do it anyway. I figure it doesn't hurt. I'm so excited to drive this car again. This probably looks so weird to people if they're just watching me do this. Hence why I'm back in a parking lot far away from a lot of stuff. But cool thing is you'll notice this thing locks up under acceleration, but on decel and coasting it really doesn't because it's a one way. Whee! I love this car so much. It's so good. It's so good. I can't wait to make it even better. Got a few little things planned for this. Nothing too major. Trying to change some stuff around suspension-wise, alignment-wise, and I've ordered some tools to hopefully help dial this thing in a little bit better next time I go to the track. So I'm gonna go get some Indian food and then we'll play around at the shop a little bit more. All right, guys, so here's my thoughts on the new twin disc in this car. The pedal pressure's almost about twice as much. It's got a much stiffer pressure plate so it can handle a bit more torque. But it's got a very good feel. And by that I mean it's a very smooth and kind of linear engagement. And what's cool about it, this clutch actually has one disc that's sprung, so it kind of dampens a little bit of the aggression of how hard it grabs. I don't know, it feels like a good happy medium clutch. Not gonna lie, it's a little bit stiff for what I'd like, but it'll do. Watching a little bit of Netflix, and while I'm doing that, I have the trim from my Nice Chaser, and I don't want to put this in the Ugly Chaser, so what I'm gonna do is just wrap this trim with some of this. So I actually have spare trim for pretty much everything except for the shifter. I know I can still order a new OEM one, but in the meantime, I don't want to put this in, so I'm just gonna wrap it real quick. So, it took me about 2.5 episodes of Lost, but I feel like I did a pretty decent job at this. It should look pretty good. You know, it's not perfect, but it looks a lot better than wood grain would, I guess. Maybe not. Maybe I just wasted all that time for nothing. Sigh. Definitely one of the things you guys can look forward to. I don't know if you like the Chaser content or not, since they are kind of not the most exciting cars, but I will tell you that White Chaser, I think I've made the decision, and I guess this will be the title of the video, and I'll include like a thumbnail or something, and I'll kind of walk you guys through it. I think I'm gonna make that car even more rad than it already is, and by that I mean I think it's time to put that car on a standalone, put it on the 85, and make some power. I know I kind of tease you guys a little bit on Instagram. I might as well show you this stuff. So here's the thing, that car, it's one of my favorite cars to drive. It's just a nice, comfortable daily. And yes, more power would kind of be stupid because the car doesn't really get traction because it's got a bunch of camber and stuff, but it still has a decent amount of traction. I just can't get over how good it sounds, right? But what would make it sound even better? A set of BC264 cams. So I'm gonna be doing cams in it, hopefully get a little bit of a lope, and then we'll get a little bit more peaky power when we throw it on the dyno. So the plan is to raise the boost with a G25 660, dyno it, see what it makes on E85, or I should say Ignite Red E90. And then from there, then we can throw in the cams and the valve train from Brian Crower, and then we can kind of overlay the dynographs and see the difference that cams actually make. Because I know on 1Js, it's pretty easy just to leave everything stock and you still make good power, but I'm curious kind of how it is going to affect that. Other stuff, I might as well show you all we have going in here. In the missile car, I do plan on eventually doing the same defi setup that I have in my Ebisu car. So I got some defis to put in the dash. So I have all my gauges for turbo, oil temp, water temp, oil pressure, and then the little sending unit. So, like I said, going back to the White Chaser, cams, injectors, fuel pump, ECU, tune. It should make like 550, 600 horsepower. Sounds super rad. I don't know if the clutch is gonna hold it. I think I'm just gonna wing it because it is, I do think the clutch will hold it. It's a 350Z clutch because it's like the CD in this one. I don't like it, I'm probably gonna eventually change it, but it does feel like it has enough bite to hopefully hold the power for a little bit, and I can change it down the road. But we are going to turn this thing into a fast, pretty daily, so. As much as I love these wheels and the stance, I am contemplating maybe getting a little bit less aggressive offset wheels, because these I could in theory have something in a little bit more and then run a little bit more tire, because right now I've only got like a 235 in back and I still have plenty of room on the inside, so I can go a little bit higher offset. It'll let me fit a better tire and then I can hopefully get a little bit more traction. So I don't know, I love this car so much. And I just feel like it'd be rad. It's still gonna be super simple. The turbo setup's already all done and everything. It's just a little fuel so I can turn the boost up. It's gonna be sick. It's just gonna make cool noises and I'm excited. This is something that I know I've talked to you guys about the R34 and been like, it's probably not gonna have for a month or two because I'm waiting on parts. This stuff's all simple. I could probably get everything in, get it tuned within like a day or two. It's gonna happen once I'm back from Connecticut. I'm doing like a little trip up there in the winter. That is the goal right now, is to get the parts in for this thing, get this thing ripping. When I'm back, we also are doing a bigger turbo on my Supra. I guess I could tell you what I'm doing on that. Or should I not? Should I? I would love to going back to watching Lost and wrapping things vinyl, but I'm gonna go bowling with Matt the Ginge and friends. Still trying to somewhat chill on this holiday break. It's hard for me to do that when there's always so much going on and stuff to do. But anyway, I got some little maintenance done in the Evo. I'm gonna keep driving that thing around, break everything in a little bit more. And then let me know what you guys want to see tomorrow, anything you want to see me talk about. It's kind of hard because most of the major projects are kind of finished up right now, kind of wrapped up. Alberto's in Puerto Rico. Everyone's kind of all over the place, and there's really nothing major in my head that I can be doing on any of the cars. But maybe I'm forgetting something. Maybe you guys have some sort of input. I don't know. Regardless, I'm sorry that this video was so all over the place. I hope you guys still enjoyed it. I'm sorry if this camera sucks. I'm going to go back to the old camera tomorrow if you guys hate it. But I appreciate you. Hope you enjoyed that video yesterday. That was something I've been dying to release, but I had to wait until the day after Christmas to put it out. So hope you like it. Hope you like this video. And I'll see you guys tomorrow.